Quantitative analysis, how does it work with an internal standard? Well, it's the same in that a bigger peak is more. It's still the area under the curve. A smaller peak is less. It's still the area under the curve. But a standard has been added to both the samples and the standards and the controls, and that internal standard is tracked through the extraction and the preparation of the sample, through the analysis, and the results are normalized according to the quantitation of the internal standard. So let's take a look at this chromatogram. We have a 50 standard. It's given us a 115. So if we'd have gotten like 200, then that would be 100 or something like that. If we'd gotten 50, that would be like 25 or something like that. Just the same. But the thing that's different is that now our standard is normalized according to another peak called the internal standard. So that, let's say for example, the injection doesn't work quite right and you only get, instead of 1 microliter, you get a 0.5 microliter. Well, both peaks will be half as big, approximately, but the ratio will still be the same, so you can still use this standard. Let's look at an unknown now. Okay, we have the benzene in the unknown comes in at a 34. The internal standard comes in at a 44, so comes in at a 42. So if we look at this, we'll see that the peak is much smaller. Okay, so from 115 we've gone to a 34, and the internal standard is actually a little bit bigger, so the ratio is significantly smaller. So how do we calculate this? The way I do this is I take the 50 and I say, what do I want to do to this 50 to get me to where I want to be? I say, let's multiply the 50 by the small number on top and the big number on the bottom. And so that's 42 over 34. The ratios have to be set up the same, so let's check it out. We've got 37 IS over the standard value of 115. We've got 42 IS over the unknown value of 34. That looks pretty good. Let's go ahead and calculate this. 50 times 37 times 34 divided by 115 divided by 42, and we get 13.0. And this, of course, is in the units in however you started out with. And that's all there is to it. Two last points. The first one is that this is simple from a mathematical standpoint, but not simple from a conceptual standpoint. And it's important. This is at the center of math literacy. So take your time and be patient with yourself especially, but also with your teacher and your books, and be patient with me. And then the last point is this one. Many years ago, when I was a young laboratory technician, I worked in a toxicology laboratory. We did drug analysis on therapeutic drugs. It was a graveyard shift job. There were bunches and bunches of different drugs, and typically they come in one at a time. We had HPLCs, liquid chromatography, with little first-generation Hewlett-Packard integrators. The instrumentation would give us the area under the curve, but it was just as easy for us to just manually calculate them. I mean, rather than set up a method and stuff, you just run a standard, run a control, bump, 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 bump through the calculations and write them out, put a little note on the report and go on to the next one. It was easier to do it manually. The formula we used is this one right here. And it was in a big poster on the, it was in a big poster on the wall. And, you know, after a while, you just learn to memorize it. It's not hard to do it manually. And people do it manually sometimes. Thank you.